my laptop is not working for some reason. My laptop literally stopped working. So as you saw from the last video, my laptop's not working anymore. The hard drive is not working, so we're getting it fixed. But in the meantime, things are still going on. I still have school, I still have online school, which just means a laptop is essential. But I don't have it. Originally, I was just gonna use my grandpa's desktop, but you know, it is only for a day because the weekends are coming. So I decided, why not try using my phone to see how things work out. Alright, just got done with first class. We didn't really do much, we just listened, so using a phone wasn't that bad. But next class is writing, so I'm pretty sure I'm gonna have to use this keyboard. I don't like using this keyboard, because I don't know why, but my hand, it hurts. It doesn't hurt, but like it kind of aches when I use it. I don't know if it's the form or whatever, but I don't like using it much, but I mean, it's better than doing this. Yeah, second class. Today in writing, we have to write an essay that's due at 1 p.m. It's like 11 right now, so he just ended the Zoom, and we have to rejoin at 11:30 if we have questions or not. Yeah, so I'm gonna get writing this essay. One struggle of a phone is a really small screen. Laptops are like this, phones are like this. So when a teacher is like screen sharing in class, or when I wanna do something, like see a document or something, it's super, super small. Another thing is typing out things. Because it is online, you have to type out a lot of your assignments. And you know, on the phone, all you can really do is this. So, you know, that's kind of difficult to be doing for like essays and stuff like that. The great thing is I do have this Bluetooth keyboard that can connect to my phone. So luckily I have that, or else I probably wouldn't be doing this. All right, turned in my assignment. It's lunch, it's about 12:30. Now I'm entering my third class, which is music. Alright, so that took like 15 minutes. She gave us time to do like our missing assignments for her class. I have two, so I'm gonna do that now. And then we'll have fourth period, which is social studies. And then when social studies is done, I'll do all the missing assignments I have to do for all the classes, because grades for the first quarter are going in at the end of next week. So I wanna finish missing assignments now, so I don't have to worry about it next week, because like I'm cutting it close. This is too confusing. How am I supposed to do that? Another thing that isn't really the greatest is the mobile versions of all the apps. They're not terrible, but some of them, like Google Docs and Google Slides, don't have some features that are on PC. And even if they did have those features, it would be hard to find where they were. It's just hard and different using mobile versions of the things you usually use on your laptop. I give up. This is way too hard. I have class in like 10 minutes, so I'll take like a 10 minute break, do class, and then I'll get back to this. It's way too hard. One of the main things is multitasking. When you're in a Zoom, teachers are obviously gonna tell you to be doing assignments, and usually you could just have another tab open and simple, just click on the other tab or Alt tab. But you can't do that on the phone. I guess it is simple to just go around scrolling around like this. But when your phone is propped up, that's pretty difficult to do. And if you're switching constantly, like I usually do, between multiple different apps, that takes a while. Right now I'm done with class. Now I have to do and catch up on a lot of homework. Thankfully though, I am getting my laptop back tomorrow, or when you see this video, I already have it back probably. So I only had to struggle with this for a day, but that just goes to show how much of an essential a laptop is for online school. But anyways, that is it for me. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to subscribe, hit the like button, and I'll see you in the next video.